Sekreteri Penat'ta, Ambassador, Distinguished, Dear Friends, Ladies and Gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to address such a distinguished audience on the occasion of the annual conference of American Turkish Council. I would like to express that efforts made in support of this platform is worth every appreciation. This prestigious council adds tremendously to our friendship with its high-level meetings, gathering the most distinguished businessmen and statesmen of both sides. This meeting, which is a good opportunity to develop the common thinking, enriches us with new visions and brings closer our approach towards the global and regional challenges. I would like to extend my thanks to the organizer of this wonderful evening. Thank you very much for your invitation and invaluable contribution to strengthen the United States-Turkey relations. Distinguished guests, Turkish-American relations have a long history, always aiming to reach the common goals of peace and freedom all over the world. We are bound up with a multifaceted relationship stemming from the common history, mutual respect, and shared vision. Our nations have common values such as democracy, freedom, respect for human rights, and the market economy. We perceive Turkey and the United States as two indispensable allies with common goals of peace and stability. It is important that both our countries act in line with this understanding. Turkey has always pursued and has been guided by the Atatürk's ideal, which is peace at home, peace in the world. There is no doubt that the United States shares this ideal. Military relations are also a part of cooperation between our respective countries. Our alliance has already been proved and fortified through the close cooperation for many years. 2012 marks the 60th anniversary of Turkey's membership to NATO. Throughout its membership, Turkey has been a major security provider. Turkey will continue to make its contribution to the alliance mission. As you know, we had the NATO summit last month in Chicago. Thanks for Leon Panetta for kind hospitality extended to us. There we emphasized the importance of the reforms and renewed our commitment to vital transatlantic bond to the ongoing operation. In this summit, innovative approaches for the future were expressed and defense package was approved to handle the capability requirements of NATO with a perspective for 2020 and beyond. NATO has proven that it is not only a military organization, but also a political consultative structure, which provides an important contribution to the international peace and stability. It has the intention to promote the political dialogue and practical cooperation. As Turkey, we fully appreciate and support the role of our alliance in the framework of collective defense and security. Ladies and gentlemen, Turkish-American relations have always been influenced by the set of structural and institutional factors, which can be regarded as the fundamental dynamics of bilateral relations and binational and international developments. Today's challenges, especially in the region, require better cooperation. Most of the regional issues on the agenda of the United Nations Security Council are also dealt with by both Turkey and the United States. With the intention of solving problems, both in our region and in a larger geography, Turkey declared her candidacy for the 2012-2016 term of non-permanent membership of the United Nation Security Council. In this regard, Turkey's election as a non-permanent member of the United Nations Security Council for the 2012-2016 term will match her recent foreign policy objectives and critical geopolitical situation. In this respect, it makes us happy to see our friends' support in our candidacy process. Distinguished members of the Council, terrorism is a vital and long-lasting threat to global security. Today, it is more complex and networked. We are now happy to see that fight against terrorism is a global priority. In this context, the United States is our leading partner in this field. Both Turkey and the United States are targeted by terrorist organizations, and therefore, we have a shared concern and interest on this issue. We are of the opinion that cooperation between all countries is a must to eradicate terrorism. We appreciate the United States' support in this field. Continuation of our close cooperation and coordination is important in fight against terrorism. As an outcome of our partnership and close alliance, we would be happy to see Turkey and United States cooperation against terrorist organizations continue and increase in the future. Ladies and gentlemen, let me share with you my opinion about the latest development in the Middle East, especially in Syria. At a time when the Middle East passed through an extremely critical period, Turkey attaches great importance to close dialogue and cooperation with the Arab states. Change and democratic transformation are inevitable for all regional countries in one way or another. We think that violence and disproportionate use of force by some regimes in the region is unacceptable. We believe that sustainable security and stability is only possible through meeting the legitimate aspiration of the people. In this regard, the Syrian issue is very sensitive for Turkey. The crisis in Syria resulted in serious human rights violation and deplorable humanitarian situation with the escalation of violence and the death of thousands of innocent people in Syria. Assad and his government has lost his legitimacy. Kofi Annan, United Nations Special Envoy to Syria, admitted his mediation efforts have failed in a speech at the United Nations and laid the blame at the feet of Bashar Assad and have called for international action. The international community now must take necessary action to stop violence. It is our collective responsibility to act quickly. From now on, giving any additional time to Assad will cause the death of more innocent civilians. More must be done to isolate Assad regime. Syria cannot be peaceful, stable, or certainly democratic unless to meet the legitimate aspiration of Syrian people. Syrian people want to see political transition in Syria. Refugee problem still maintains its importance. In this regard, Turkey has adopted an open door policy for every Syrian who is fleeing from the atrocities of the regime. Turkey has set up 8 camps, accommodating now around 25,000 Syrians. In the period ahead, we will continue to meet the needs of the Syrian people. Turkey will be ready to take all necessary measures if it is national security and lives of the Turkish people, as well as those of our Syrian guests in our camps along the Turkish-Syrian border, come under threat. Distinguished members of the American Turkish Council, it is clear that today's complex nature of the defense and security environment requires more enhanced cooperation between our countries. Last month in Chicago during the NATO summit, it was once again emphasized that cooperation is a key factor in order to access the new technologies and defense capabilities that our forces need in order to retain the global peace and security. Turkish defense industry has been developing remarkably. Turkey has invested in certain capabilities and gained remarkable know-how through having taken part in large multinational programs. In addition to these multinational involvement, the bilateral programs and business-to-business relations have contributed to the increase of the defense industrial cooperation capacity. Working in close cooperation with our allies and partners is a must to achieve best value in defense programs, find practical solutions, and meet our forces' requirements using the most efficient and effective methods. I am pleased to say that the level of trade volume between our respective countries in the defense industry area is highly promising. The figure of our ongoing programs exceeded $27 billion. The JSF is one of the prominent programs on which Turkey and the United States are working together. I would like to underline that using the key capabilities Turkey has invested in this project and offered efficient, unique solution with more enhanced cooperation, exclusively the engine and the landing gear final assembly and checkout lines, which will result in remarkable cost savings for overall program. Given our proven capabilities, I am confident that our companies can work together to answer today's challenges with more cost-effective solution. One of the biggest programs in Turkey's aviation history, the utility helicopter program, will be signed very soon. I hope that this project will take place in many joint programs that we have run, utilizing the capabilities of both countries. Keeping all these factors in mind, we would like to see more Turkish companies in the United States defense market working with their American counterparts and sharing know-how to meet the military needs of the United States Armed Forces as well as those of some other countries. I would like to express my appreciation that the framework for strategic, economic, and commercial cooperation constitutes a significant platform between the United States and Turkey. Turkey focuses on better cooperation with the allies, utilizing various tools such as international cooperation offices in the key regions, project partnership methods, and more Turkish investment in target countries. Joint marketing for the third countries is also an important element to sustain the defense industry base and indigenous capabilities. The defense industry relation between our countries will enhance the already existing cooperation in a mutually beneficial way in terms of trade and economy. Within this framework, such cooperation will be a strong expression of our political solidarity between the two countries. Increasing area of cooperation and joint working also enhance confidence in each other. Ladies and gentlemen, as I come to the end of my speech, I would like to thank all the members of the American Turkish Council for their commendable efforts and distinguished audience. As a bottom line, I avail myself of this opportunity to convey my best wishes to the people of the United States. Thank you. Now, I would like to invite Ambassador Richard Armitage. It's your turn. Thank you.